Jamila.
Hi, everyone. I'm so happy to be here to support my sister, Mita, and to talk to you young ladies. My story is a little bit different. So far, we've had everybody who kind of went along the straight and narrow, right path of life. But guess what? That wasn't me. That wasn't my story. I just actually came home from federal prison. I just finished serving a 12 and a half year sentence behind bars. So I was behind bars for 9 years. I'm just coming home, and just to let you know how real and how true it is, you see this bracelet on me? I got my ankle bracelet right here. I'm still custody of the BOP. So technically, I'm still an inmate. So I want to talk to you today about just life and not making the wrong poor choices. Because when I stayed behind bars for close to a decade, I left my two children behind. You know, they didn't have their mother to celebrate the holidays. They didn't have their mothers to celebrate Christmas. It was really, really, really a rough situation that I just put my kids through because I was chasing. I was chasing money. I was chasing fame. I was chasing dudes. I was doing all of the little things. And it's crazy because, you know, you may come from broken families or not so broken families, but a lot of us still face the same similar draws, you know? For me, my life went astray when I was 14 years old. I met a drug dealer from the Southside Jamaica Housing Project. And it's crazy because I grew up in a good family, but I loved this dude, or I thought I loved this dude. You feel me? Okay, you with me? Okay, maybe you did what I did. Okay, sugar, we got some, you know, some common shipping.
No, because we're both from the same neighborhood. Our parents, my dad was a principal, her mom was a teacher.
Yeah.
Okay, but we chose to do other things.
Correct. So I say this to you. So this particular boy, you know, he had a whole bunch of money. He was looking fly and everything. And, you know, I was going to school. I went to high school performing arts. So my mother helped me, you know, go get my dream. And baby, I done seen this boy. And I said, ooh, he fine. Sugar? He's fine. I like him. Girl, I ended up dating him, and he was giving me money and buying me things, and I'm like, okay, well, I can do this. And I had always saw all the other fly chicks in the neighborhood with their little drug dealing boyfriends, they had their sneakers and their little stuff. I was like, ew, you know what I mean? And I ended up getting pregnant at 14 years old, messing with this guy. Like really, really just messing my life up. You know what I'm saying? And I say this to say, I went that way and I never came back because I thought it was cute and I thought it was fly. Like, yo, I'm gonna have the illest stuff, I'm gonna do this, yeah. And now I started doing things that was really not for me to please him. Now guess what happened? He left me, y'all. And then that went really crazy because he left me for a girl that was 16 like him and she was a baker, excuse me. You know what I mean? I ain't gonna come to the baker. But she worked in a baker. Because she gets her own money. Why did he tell me that? Sugar, I was so hurt, I didn't know what to do with myself. And this is the thing. We give our bodies to people. We think that they love us. And I only saw happily ever after. I really thought I would be with this guy for the rest of my life. And could you imagine the hurt and the pain that caused me when he left me for the chick from the bakery? I never recovered. I'm gonna tell you something, I never recovered. So I went full into action. So at that point, it was like, yo, you know, he left her because she get money. So guess what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go get money, baby. And I just was dripping after that. I went and got a full-time job at 15 years old. I started working at Haagen-Dazs, collecting my money from that. Then I started dating other drug dealers. And then I learned the game. I'm like, hold up, I could do what you do. You just do that and then a little that. And then, hold on, let's put this with that. Okay? So then I started hustling. I started selling drugs. And then it just went all the way left because I was chasing acceptance. So then it got worse. Once I started getting money, I got my little car, had my little fly jewelry. You couldn't tell me nothing. Fendi this, Gucci that. You know what I mean? Miller's coming through. You know what I mean? And then they started calling me the fly girl. So everybody from the hub was like, yo, she got this. Oh, she ill. She got that. And I loved it. I wanted them to hear them say that. I wanted them to say she's this and she's that. So then it got worse. So I went from drugs to hustling credit. Okay? Now let's talk about that date. You understand what I'm trying to tell you? Now I'm getting all the rappers and all the hood guys' cars. I'm
getting them their Benzes and all their things. And, you know, this is making me feel good inside because they're saying that they love me. They're saying that they care. And I'm just chasing that money because I want more. Say it again, daddy, say it again. You understand what I'm saying? And guess what happened? I ended up with a 12 and a half year sentence behind bars. This is real, okay? So basically, when that happened, I'm thinking everybody was, all the people that love me, they're gonna be there. They're gonna support me. Guess what? They left. They left me because they didn't love me. They loved the things that I provided for them. You understand what I'm saying? And it's not until I got behind bars that I realized I didn't love myself. Because if I love myself, I would have never put myself in a situation to cause myself harm. Are you following what I'm saying? And I'm still healing, y'all. I'm not coming here to tell y'all I got it all together, because guess what? I don't. You know what I mean? Now, behind bars, I've done some great things. I have my book, She's All Caught Up, that I'm going to bring to you because I'm a writer. I'm a motivational speaker. And behind bars, I actually sat down for enough time to get my education. You know, I got my associates, my bachelor's, my master's, and I'm currently working on it. A good situation. So I'm telling y'all, there is hope. So everybody that thinks that there is no hope, there is hope. I want to just address really quickly. Like, a lot of people say, oh, because if you have this or if you do this. No, man, it's just belief. It's faith in God and believing in yourself and loving yourself. And I'm so glad that you're in this program with Mita, because I'm going to come back to talk to you guys. But love yourself. That's what you got to do first. You got to love yourself. You got to be your own best friend, your own protector, and you got to care about you. And baby, don't give your little nookies to these men, because these men ain't right. You know what I mean? Even the older ones ain't right. You know what I'm saying? You got to find your husband, somebody that loves you and cares about you for you. Because you be the kid, gave away your stuff, baby, and then they be messing with the baker. I'm not going to talk about you. You understand what I'm saying? But that's what they'll do to you. So the moral of the story is to love yourself, to be yourself, and know with God all things, not some things, all things are possible. Your past doesn't matter. Because if I go by my past, I'm a prisoner, I'm an ex-con, I'm a nothing, I'm a nobody. But you know what God says? My future is great and so is yours. So I'm speaking to every last woman in this building, and I'm encouraging you to push on, stay with Mita. We're going to get you with mentors. We're going to find out what your purpose is. We're going to find out your passion. And please don't make the bad choices I did. You don't have to, because I did them for you. Okay, y'all? All right, I'm your girl, Jamila.